up people, welcome to episode 7 of our video series Cost of Building in Ghana. Today we will be looking at the blockwork of the rooftop garden as well as the decking for the water tank. As always, we start with the pillars, and like I've indicated, the ratio is 1.5:2:4. That's 1.5 bag of cement for each pillar to 2 trucks of sand, and then 3 to 4 trucks of stones for each pillar. So once that was through, we went ahead with the block work just for the tank, the water tank area. On this level, because it was the last floor, it was 190 Ghana cedis for every 2 bags of cement used to lay blocks or used for the pillars. So that is about roughly $35 to $40. So the mason takes 100 and then the laborer takes 90. Like I indicated, for every floor it goes up by 20 Ghana cedis. So once that was through, we went ahead with the carpentry. So because it's a small area, I was charged 700 cedis, which is about $110 to $120 for the carpentry work. It took them about three or four days. So I would eventually take you through what I have done here. So the part that you see, which I've highlighted, it's the seating area, and that's about 9 feet. And then just next to it, to the left, will be the washroom. The right side of the seating area that I showed you will be a small kitchenette. It's not going to go all the way up. I intend to use glass, openable glass, so that when you are seated or you have an event to see whatever is going on, and if you are in the kitchen, you can also be part of whatever is happening in the yard. And then next to the kitchenette will be what I consider one of the important rooms in the whole apartment. Now, anytime I'm in Ghana and I notice that my wife has repacked my tools, I indicate to her that my tools are as important to me as her kitchenwares are important to her. So that room is going to be my tool room, and I can't wait to have my tools displayed in there, and that will have the same status as my wife's kitchen. So I wouldn't countenance any messing up of my tools in there. Anyway, that's just by the way. So once we're done with the carpentry, we went ahead with the perimeter wall for the garden. So we laid 4 courses, and again it was 190 cedis like I have indicated, and the mortar mixture was every 2 bag of cement to 5 wheelbarrows of sand. Once that was done, we went ahead with the casting. That's the slab for where the tank will be. Unfortunately, I was unable to find the reinforcement video for the water tank decking. If I happen to find it later, I will share it in future episodes. But for the reinforcement, because of the water that was going to be there, I used 14mm for the primary bars, and then the normal 11.5 for the secondary bars. In simple terms, I made the 14mm, I laid it in on the longitudinal side, and then I put the 11.5mm across on the shorter side. So as you can see, the first tank is fixed already, and you will notice from the pipe showing on your screen, we intend to continue to have the other two as I indicated, to make it easier so that when they have to fill the tank up, they don't have to pass their holes on the wall to get them to get it dirty. I have 2 inches pipe from the down all the way to the top. It's not too clear in here, but maybe when we get to the 2-bedroom side casting, you probably may see the pipe. This is where you have an advantage when you are building your house. You have the chance to design it based on your regular needs. Usually people forget to put in these pipes, and you will notice that anytime water has to be filled, you will see them having to look for ladder or having to pass the hose on the walls of the building. That dirties it. So even if it's a single story, I think it's prudent that you have a pipe down and then you can have it connected, because the pumps they use are quite powerful and it should be able to pump all the way. You would notice that I have extended, I made the cover of the sitting area concrete, and the reason is I intend to put my solar panels there. Okay, so let's look at the total cost for the block work for the rooftop garden and then that of the water tank area. So I have already colored it as usual. We will then sort. I have already colored them, so we will sort by color. So for that area mentioned, this was a rather small job, so I don't think the cost is going to be much. Yep, so that was 24,000 Ghana cedis, which should be about $5,000. Okay, and regarding the Excel template, I had already replied in earlier comment why I'm unable to share the file as it is. Apart from the fact that the prices may be outdated, the main reason is I have some names in there because of how I pay people. I indicated that you can always pause the video and check the screen to see whatever costing you have there. Before we move on to the bonus discussions, I just want to say we were overwhelmed with the responses, the emails that came through after we shared the email, our email in the last episode. We appreciate you getting back, and we had so many emails, some of you sharing your experiences, good and bad, with us. And what crossed my mind was we probably should consider having a session in the bonus discussion where our audience who are interested can send us a video of their unpleasant experiences with their building project for us to learn. The point is, it's all a learning platform for everyone so that people don't make those same mistakes. So if you are interested, you can make a video of yourself, send us the images or videos of whatever you are describing. I'll piece them together and then include them in the bonus discussion so that people who are also building can learn from that. So if you are interested, just you can indicate that in the comment section, or just send them to my email and I will include them possibly even in the next episode under the bonus discussion. If you don't want the video option and you want audio, you can just do the audio narration and then send it together with the pictures or video that you are talking about or you will be referring to in your audio. And again, I would piece them together and then have them included in the bonus discussion session so that everyone can learn. But we are not contractors to try and impress people to get clients. The bottom line is we are sharing what we are doing. So if you also want to share so that others will learn and at least make progress with building their dream house or successfully pursuing their real estate investment ambitions, feel free to share. Okay, so for the bonus discussions for today, we'll be looking at two things. First is the digging fee, which was requested by one of our audience. And also, we'll share with you some things that you can buy in bits as you build, especially if you go down to Ghana regularly. These are things that we have bought. We think it's worth sharing so that you don't wait until the last minute to buy them. So, for the digging fee, the thing is you cannot escape it, because looking at our location, which is a built-up area, as soon as we started, they showed up. So, they started with from 2,000 cedis, which was about $500. At that point, I knew most of the time the amount that is charged, 1,000 cedis or 2,200, which is about $200 to $250. So, I told them to reduce it and they said the last was 1,000. So I told them I would get back to them. But then I told them, because of experiences of other people, that I wasn't going to give them all, because usually if you pay, a different group will come, and sometimes it is planned. Once you give them the money, they will go bring another group. So I told them I will need to go to where the chief is and find out the youth leader. Or they call them a branty, you know. The thing is, you, when they come to the site, you shouldn't resist them. Let them appreciate that you know it is customary and you have to pay. The only thing is, you just need to be sure you are paying to the right person, and they will understand. As soon as they come and you make them aware, it is not a problem, because you know it is custom. Immediately all the tensions and the apprehension ceases, and they begin to listen to you. They realize that you know the processes and they are going to be very accommodating, especially if they are genuine. For the next topic, we just thought we should share this, because one of the emails that we got was if we are buying our fixtures from Ghana or outside. And I felt we should touch on this as a free tip for some of you who at least go to Ghana once or twice a year. For some of the things, I feel it is worth buying from Europe or the Americas or Asia, wherever you may find yourself. And I would briefly explain. So for instance, we plan to use smart switches for all the rooms. Of course, for its obvious advantages, you can control with your phone. You don't need to have those multiple switches, controls, and so on. You can get that in Ghana, but it may be a little bit more expensive. You can get a smart switch for about $15 and $25. It's just like any normal switch. If you happen to buy five anytime you are going to Ghana, is you just fit it in your bag, carry-on bag, or your check-in luggage, and that should be it. By the time you are done with your project, you have all the necessary smart switches that you need. Well, if you're going to buy these smart switches in Ghana, they may be more expensive. I haven't checked, but definitely going to be more expensive than you buying it here for about between $15 and $25 or euros. The other thing we bought is intercom. Even though we don't need them now, we just felt that anytime I'm going, I could just buy them and put them in my bag. So just buy the handset, buy the intercom system, and you should be good. For our intercom system, we bought the Kame BPT branded intercom. I don't know if I got the name right, but I believe the Kame brand is a UK company. For the 6 units, it was about $500 to $600. So those are handy stuff you could easily pack in your bag as well. And by the way, this was not a camera one, it's just a normal audio. Again, you can also buy your CCTV security cameras. It's cheaper if you buy it out. We bought a set. We didn't have a hard disk, so we bought either 1 terabyte or 500 gig hard disks. You could also buy your gate motors to motorize the gate. Now, this was so important to us, because one of the things that we find it difficult doing where we currently live is step out and you are getting back. You now have to get out the car, especially when you are getting back late, to go and open the gate. If you have a gate man or a security man, no problem. motor. The motor weighed about 10 kilos, so it comfortably went into my bag. That I bought for, I think the motor cost 2000 cedis, which is about $500, and that is for a 600 kg load. If I'm to buy that in Ghana, I'm sure it's going to cost me almost twice the price. And then another tool that you can have for your personal use, apart from the power tools I mentioned in the previous episode, is also a laser tape measure, which you can see. This comes in handy, especially when you go to the site. Another thing you could comfortably buy will be the faucets and then the taps. And these are of good quality. And of course, if you are buying that same brand in Ghana, it's going to cost you so much. So what is a big deal if you go in and you have space in your luggage, you can just drop that in. As you would notice, another thing that I bought from outside Ghana would be a flow meter, and I will explain to you why I did that. You see the installation. I may show that probably in the next 2 or 3 episodes, so just stay tuned. Some of you wanted to know the plan for the penthouse. Now the penthouse itself is the same 3-bedroom, but for the rooftop garden I have multiple concepts. If you want a more elaborate penthouse, what I could suggest is you could halve the rooftop garden area and then extend the 3-bedroom underneath upwards, so you have 2 floors living area, and then you have half of the rooftop garden that I currently have. So what it means is that the areas before the visitors washroom at the 3-bedroom side could comfortably have a stairs up, so you can have some rooms up there, and then you have an exit also to your rooftop garden or balcony or whatever you would want to call it. So that's a free idea for you. If you want something more elaborate, it will come with a little bit of cost, but I think if you want more elaborate stuff, it definitely should come with a little bit of cost. Plus you can have 2 more rooms up there and even a family area. Some of you also requested for a phone number. We managed to get a phone number for WhatsApp, but we are still trying to figure out the best way to get that communication going, so that we can make time on Sundays, because it's on Sundays that we start the video, and it's on this same day that we are able to, we would have to use to communicate with those who want to communicate with us on phone. So hopefully by the end of this month, that's February, we should come up with the necessary plan, and then we would let you know. So that is it for this episode. Feel free to post all your questions in the comment section below. No, we certainly do answer all questions on Sundays. Please don't reply to someone's comment with your question, because it doesn't show in the comments that I haven't answered. So I may skip that. And for those that I promised I was going to respond to your mails, because of the nature of your request, I haven't forgotten. This week was a little bit packed for us, so just be patient. We're definitely going to respond to it. Thank you for watching. So watch out for the next episode, and see you in a bit. Enjoy, people.